Good morning, everyone. First thing is, you should know the syllabus, which is very essential. Generally, people do not know syllabus. That's why I wrote, it is not needed to write. Already you have syllabus, but you need to know the syllabus. Accordingly, you need to prepare and focus on your examination. The first topic deals with theoretical aspect, all the theoretical aspects of ethics, which you can consider as the core of the ethics. How we explain anything theoretically. Any subject has theoretical dimension if you have some optionals. So you can find it how there are certain theoretical aspect of that discipline. So first chapter is about theoretical aspects. We'll deal what are those theories. And that is the core aspect of ethics. So which takes, you can say that your most of the time, if you understand the theory, you understand everything. So that is how we'll be explaining this first chapter. Within that, there are two other aspects, which we say as public and private relations, ethics in public and private relation. Question already has been asked in 2015 and 16. every year they ask question from this. There is no, let's say that theory is very important, so any question you can link with theory, but they have asked specific questions as well. Aptitude, so they have not asked a question so far, but on foundational values, every year they ask one question. And most important question which they have repeated three times is called conflict of interest. They have repeated, means three times they have asked so far. Attitude, two times question has been asked. It is related to your attitude, what attitude we carry, and there are again theoretical aspect about attitude, then social influence. Once they have asked the question in 2016, they ask Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. So you can see that they ask a question related to a scheme, and on that scheme you have to write ki how Swachh Bharat Abhiyan brings social influence and persuasion among people. So it was a difficult question to apply. They have not asked so far question from this political attitude, so we expect a question from this. Emotional intelligence, they have been asking question, and in 2013 itself they asked question on emotional intelligence. And still last year also I guess they have asked indirect question. In fact, emotional intelligence has its application in any such context. As emotional intelligence determine your ability to react in a given situation, how you react, how you make decision. This chapter is entire public administration, means we can say ethics. So it is about entire civil services. Civil services, that you want to become civil servant, and civil services have lots of values, etc., issues, all these things will be dealt by this topic. Within this topic, there will be, let's say that, four or five other topics. So it is a very big chapter. And similarly, probity in governance, another big chapter, of which some topics overlap with your paper second as well, RTI, Citizen Charter, etc. And probity in governance as such, so from this probity question has not been asked. So we have been expecting a question also on the term probity. And then this moral philosopher and thinkers. So they have been asking every year question, and it is not necessary that they will ask question only on moral philosophers which you know. They can ask even Napoleon, a question on Napoleon also, who is not a moral thinker but more as a leader. So that is how about syllabus, that you should know that. This chapter, if you go for some classification of the chapters, so this will be more philosophical oriented. So it will be more philosophical oriented. Similarly, this already it is also. So first, and let's say if you add seventh, so they are more philosophical oriented. If you take the three chapters, this second, third and fourth, so they have been taken largely from your psychology. So they are more psychological oriented. It is about human psychology. So attitude and emotional intelligence. But this psychology, just you have to understand human psychology. You have to understand your psychology. But it should be applied in context of administration, in the context of society. So there are certain conceptual aspects. The way there is philosophical aspect, so you have to understand certain philosophical aspect. You cannot write a general answer, let's say. That means general in the sense that you cannot have historical approach, geographical approach. You cannot have Lakshmikant approach, means polity approach. You can have, let's say, only ethical approach. What is ethical approach? That is how you have to understand. And then if you relate this fifth and sixth, either you put the two subjects called pole science and public administration. So in a way you will see that this chapter is combination of philosophy, psychology, pole science, public administration, plus sociology also we cannot leave it, otherwise there will be discrimination. So, some aspects of sociology also. because you will have to deal with society, like say attitudes. So attitude, we have to deal with society. Already they have asked, society has conflicting attitude. This question was asked in 2015. So why society has conflicting attitude? So they ask a question not related to largely psychology, but it was a more society-based question. So you have to have certain understanding of. Sociology means it demands interdisciplinary approach. So this paper is neither philosophy nor public administration, nor sociology, nor psychology, whatever you can say, it is more of. You have to have general understanding of all these subjects so that you can explain whatever the given question. So syllabus you must know. Why you must know syllabus? For your planned preparation. Suppose any question, let's say that article has come in newspaper. So when any article has come in newspaper, can you relate if it has certain ethical dimension? So can you relate with your any such ethics topic? So you can relate only when you know the topics. If you know that there is emotional intelligence, and let's say that any such incident which has come related to emotional intelligence, so you can relate it. And that is how you can enhance your understanding. By reading books only, you cannot enhance understanding on ethics. You can enhance more theoretical understanding. You cannot enhance applied understanding. Applied in the sense, when a question is asked, right, how Swachh Bharat Abhiyan and social influence, they are related. Or how in Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, there is act of social influence. So how can you write it? So unless you have thought over in examination, let's say you don't have time to think. If you think, you cannot write. So that is how, let's say that newspaper, whatever you are reading, or what the first three papers you are reading, you have to have also one such mind that is called ethical mind. And you have to relate the different topics. And that is how you can make one such strategy. One such strategy that you write the six chapters in a copy, and let's say that whatever the newspaper, any other such event, incident, article, etc., which you find that it is related to that topic, so take that article and simply, let's say, cut and paste. In 1 year, you will have a good resource for ethics. Or by the time you appear in main examination, you have, let's say, good resource on ethics. And you can write, let's say, that you will not struggle to give examples. Largely, the problem is that you know the theory, but you don't know examples. And you cannot write ethics paper without examples. Right? Because you are not writing something. Suppose you have to write, what do you understand by ethics? How it is different from morality? Very simple question. So how you'll differentiate it? You cannot differentiate unless you know examples. What do you understand by competence? And how ethics will enhance competence? That is another question. Both questions have been asked. So you know what is competence. But how ethics will help in enhancing competence? This second part you cannot write without examples. So do you have, let's say, or you keep writing the same example again and again in the copy? Right. Because some questions will have similar nature. So will you write the same example? If you write the same examples, what happens? You know, you have dearth of example. So, and you cannot create example in examination time. As I told that, if you think in examination, so you cannot write. Either you can write or you can think. So you cannot do both in 3 hours. It means you have to, let's say, that's why syllabus, I wrote, the purpose is this. So you need to make it. If you don't want to make, don't make it. Right. It is up to you how you want to follow it. So you need to have this. You need to relate it. The better sources you can find. टाइम्स लेट्स से दैट की टाइम्स ऑफ इंडिया राइट्स स्पीकिंग ट्री. सो स्पीकिंग ट्री लेट्स से दैट नॉट एवरी डे स्पीकिंग ट्री कैन हैव गुड आर्टिकल बट एट टाइम्स इट गिव्स यू गुड आर्टिकल. लाइक टू डेज बैक देर वॉज वन आर्टिकल इफ यू ओवरकम ईगो तो यू बिकम अ रियल पर्सन यू इन्वेंट योर रियल सेल्फ. सो आर्टिकल वॉज दिस if you overcome your ego so you become the real self right or you know what you are that was the article. So and this kind of articles you cannot get in books. Now you can miss this. Similarly let's say that any incident happened, suppose Punjab National Bank means PNB scam has happened. So you find articles from different perspective, from economic perspective, from regulatory perspective, from auditing perspective, from vigilance perspective. So you get different articles which can be relevant to your paper 2nd or paper 3. But do you find any article from ethical perspective? And some articles have been written from ethical perspective also. The only thing is that you have to notice it. The only thing is that you have to know it. And few articles have also been written from ethical perspective. And from that ethical perspective, what they say, that no amount of law, institution, regulation can address PNB type of scam. Unless you change the work culture. Unless you change the value of the person who for 7 years was giving letter of undertaking. Unless that person's value is changed, unless the person who controls him, their value is changed, you cannot stop this kind of corruption. And corruption happens everywhere. It's not India. It's a matter of degree, not kind. So, do you have an idea on that aspect? Can you think on that aspect? This is how it is. Many issues are, let's say, in our society. Let's say that you had debate on capital punishment recently. Do you think from moral perspective? When a question is asked that capital punishment can be legally acceptable but not morally it is acceptable. Examine. This is a question. So you know capital punishment from Lakshmikant perspective means paper 2nd. So generally I refer to Lakshmikant paper 2nd synonymous, so because he is popular. So the question is that largely you study paper 2nd, you can write a good answer on capital punishment, but can you logic from moral perspective? So you may not logic. Otherwise means you will have to have moral philosophy. So you should have moral philosophy knowledge. Right. And unless you have knowledge on moral philosophy, then you will give the same logic. It has lost deterrence, it human right, etc. This is what the points will write. How it is different from the answer in, let's say, paper 2nd. And these things will not be built in a day. Similarly, when you have Sabarimala incident, have you seen from moral perspective that incident? You see from legal perspective. You see from social perspective. Do you see from ethical perspective? So if you have, let's say that you develop this kind of ethical perspective, then you will be able to logic it, reason it, and then you will be able to write answers. So one strategy is, let's say newspaper, others are the very biggest source, and gradual learning has no substitute, you should know that. Don't think that ki one day you will learn everything. It is not going to happen. Gradual learning, if you start seeing articles, clubbing the articles, and let's say hence 6 months hence, so you'll find at least suppose 10 articles you have, 15 articles you have, at least 15 sources you have which other people will not have. So this is how strategy for this, and that's why you should know the syllabus. As we know that most of the people do not know syllabus, they don't follow syllabus. If you don't follow syllabus, you will not have idea of what questions have been asked, what questions are going to be asked. So when we'll write details of the syllabus one by one and when we'll deal the topics separately, then we'll tell you that ki which topic they have asked, within the topic, subtopics, which question they have asked, which question they will ask. And it is quite, some questions are quite predictable, like last year corporate governance question was quite predictable because since till 2016 they had not asked corporate governance. It was very obvious ki today or tomorrow they will ask. Similarly, they have not asked political attitude. It is very obvious ki today or tomorrow they will ask. Either you wait for that to be asked, then you prepare, or you prepare in advance. So again, it is up to you, but that's why you get the understanding. That's why syllabus knowledge is a precondition. In fact, in any paper, you must know syllabus. And you should prepare as per syllabus. Now, the second thing is, before you take, we take what is ethics, etc. If you talk on sources of reading, class wrote that will dictate. Right. It will, since we teach it very properly, dictate as well, so you can say that it can almost solve your problem. Right. But still, I will say, let's say that 80%, right, it will address your problem provided you understand what is taught in the class and you apply that. Right. Still, you know that human understanding should be enhanced, and for enhancing human understanding, let's say that to search gold, you have to dig up tons of dirt. Right. You cannot get gold. Right, at one point, let's say, you must have to dig up dirt, let's say that. It means you have to read many things, then you'll find some gold. And that's why it is important to read some other things also. And then we'll give you some printed notes. This is for your reference. Right, this you should make base. But this is for your reference. Printed notes you take for reference because it is also syllabus-wise, so wherever you find it, you have not understood what I was talking, right? Although we'll ensure that you understand, still some iota of things are left, so let's say you can refer. Refer that what is written in the printed notes, etc., so that you can enhance your understanding. So it is for reference, it is not a base book. It should be the base. Then we'll also give you one, let's say that values, in administration, a PDF file of DOPT. It is a 75-page document. Although it is more than 250-page document, if you want to read yourself, you can download. Right. But we will give you 75 pages. It's very lucid. let's say that resource prepared by United Nations on the behalf of DOPT. It is a training manual for civil servants, and it writes very, let's say, lucidly about ethics and referring our certain, let's say, Mahabharata, Ramayana, etc., it refers. So that is how we generally provide because we find it is a good source. Plus, we'll be giving again, let's say, that printed resource in terms of model answer for both theory and case study that you will get, that will also enhance your understanding. Then there is ethics in governance by ARC second report, fourth report, so you can read it. Since name is ethics in governance, so it is related to ethics paper. So you can read it. It will help in also other papers as well, and enhancing knowledge about civil service edge. This plus we refer, let's say that R.K. Arora. Values in civil services. This is a textbook. Depends your penchant for reading. Read. But it may not be a right time for to take this book because it is a very thick book and it will help in paper second as well. If you have lack of knowledge, understanding, if you think a government, machineries, governance, civil service, right, RTI, Lokayukta, etc. These things are very problematic for you, so you must read this book. And if you understand all these things, right, if you understand Lokayukta, if you understand Lokpal, if you understand CVC, CBI, all these things, governance, you understand accountability, so then it may not be needed. But largely people, let's say, having not the such background, because Lakshmikant alone is not going to help. You should know that. Lakshmikant is not a book now which can help you in governance related matters and topics. And it will help only in polity, system of polity. So that's why this is a relevant book. You can, if you have problems, you can take this. So these are the sources. Apart from that, you generally take Lucent. Lucent means you take lexicon. Sorry, yes. So lexicon, let's say, there is also lexicon, a small book, popular, right. Lexicon gives you lucid understanding about certain terms and certain concepts. So that can also be taken if you wish to. That is how we can tell on the sources, etc. Now, most of the books will tell you topic first. Most of the books will talk you about topic first. I told you theoretical aspect of ethics. So whatever the books you have in market, it is nothing but they are always talking this 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 0. Right. Means no need to talk, buy many books. They will not help you. Rather, they will confuse you. Because they will talk on only topic one, and they will talk even which is not needed. Too much of philosophy, and too many of philosophers. But if you count who have been asked so far, Mahatma Gandhi, Abraham Lincoln, APJ Abdul Kalam, Napoleon, Kant, Aristotle, and theory of justice, John Rawls, Cotillia, Max Weber. So how many? 8. In 6 years, they have asked 8 philosophers. And this year, they also ask Tirukul. It means they want to be within India also. Right. So they ask Tirukul. Let's say next time, they can ask Mahabharata. Right. So the question is that if you take the question philosophers and philosophy, so you don't have to read all those name number of philosophers given right, in books, etc., you have to master this, let's say 10, so you can have more, 15 and 20, not more than that. So, and they are going to repeat them. Gandhi, Mahatma Gandhi will be repeated. Right, Kautilya will be repeated because you don't have second Kautilya to be asked. So, Kautilya will be repeated, Aristotle will be repeated. So they are going to be repeated. And that's why let's say that we don't have to read all those things which people are worried about. How many philosophers I should read, philosophy I should read, but you don't, let's say that go in that way. So you should not follow this kind of approach and get confused to yourself. Rather, whatever the topics we have, we need to know concept, application, example. This is what 3 things you need to know. Do you understand the concept? What is attitude? Do you know its application? And do you know certain examples to refer? That is what you have to know. And if you know concept, you know application. Application is the most difficult So if you know concept, application, this is how you know. So they will talk about topic one. But if you see the papers, questions are not asked only from topic one. Questions are asked from other topics. So what you will do? Great. People don't have a basic concept of emotional intelligence when it is asked, because they have not read. Books will not talk. Right. That is how it is. So ethics paper is not about only ethics. This you should know. Ethics paper is not only about theories of ethics. It is more than that. Theories of ethics will cover one third almost. Right. So they will cover one third. It means ki two third you have rest. If you are having again understanding on ethics, so you have understanding of one third, not the entire aspect. That is how, let's say, that came. You need to have the approach. Next approach is, see, we follow our approach to empower. This is what you can say. We believe in empowering you. We don't believe in spoon feeding. Spoon feeding in the sense that ki teach in such a fashion that ki you can memorize some of the concepts, some of the terms, and then on the basis of memorization, etc., read these notes. No. Read these notes and then you can go and write answer. No. We'll try to develop your ability of critical thinking, logicking, and reasoning so that you can yourself write. And that is how the ability you should develop. And it takes time, you know that. Teaching some topics, memorizing it, so it does not take much time. But when you develop an ability so that if a question is given, so you can logic yourself, you can reason yourself, read, and then you can write. And that is how, certainly, let's say that concepts and theory, etc., will help. You need to have the conceptual clarity. But at the same time, let's say that you have to apply, right? When, let's say, a question is asked, that this leaders, teachers, and parents, so they play important role in the life of children, right? This is the philosophy of APJ Abdul Kalam. Question is asked in 2016 or 17. Let's be safe. Right. So there is no any 16-17 examination. Right. So either it was in 16 or 17, suppose if you take. Now question is given that it was again a expected question. Right. So the question is that what you will write? Very simple question. You understand it? There is nothing to understand. Right. Teachers, leaders, and parents play important role in the life of children. Comment. You are in a lurch. What to write? Where to start? Where to end? How much to write? Right. Now, do you have example of any leader? Do you have example of any teacher? And do you have example of any parent? Right. Who can you relate? So can you write? This is how it is. It is shapeless. It does not have any shape. We ask another question. Right. So, discuss the problems and challenges of Doha Development Round of WTO. So, aapko at least WTO ke bare mein pata hai. You know something on WTO. WTO is this, that. Right. Then you'll write about Doha Development Round, this, that. Something you know on that. Right. And challenge and problem you have to write. So kuch to yaad hoga, you can write it. Something will have in mind. There is no challenge. The challenge only is that you should know what is Doha Development Round. And if you know, so it is already structured. But this question, right, this question, so you have to structure also, you have to bring example also, right, and you have to think what extent I have to prove it. Yes, it is right, it is wrong, I should agree, I should disagree, what I should do. Right, this is how. So, that will be a challenge in this paper. This is how, even case study not structured. Right, case study is also not structured. What they ask, you are going to appear in interview, on the way you get an old lady and she has some health problem, then what you should do? Discuss your response. And you have to discuss your response in 250 words. What you will discuss? So how will you structure it? What you will write exactly? Whether you will go to interview or you should go for help, what you should do? How you balance it? So that demands, let's say, lots of your thinking process. Do you have ability to think, logic, elaborate, read? And that is how the ability you need to develop. Rote memorization will fail. Memorization, what you will memorize? You may have memorized teacher example, you may have memorized parent, you first time you face, leader you may know. But very difficult to get any good leader now. So you'll think whether I should write Anna Hazare or Modi ji or which leader I give example. Right. So that is how the challenge, let's say, but it is not as challenging. Right. We'll not try to make it as difficult. This is how it is. Now let's talk. Suppose I'm giving example of some leaders. Some leaders example let's take. Let's take Rahul Gandhi also. So why you laugh? Right. Let's say Modi ji also. Right. Any leader, let's say that. Let's write Vajpayee also. Let's write APJ Pula also. Let's write Mahatma Gandhi also. What do you find difference? I think you know, at least you have heard. Right. What is the difference between them? Yes. Who is the best leader among them? Modi better than Mahatma Gandhi? Yes. Who is the best leader? Forget about time and space. Talk in general. Let's take. Yes. And in terms of? Right. Basically, if you talk, let's say, the clubbing, why we have given this? Right. Yes, you can have your personal view. Suppose somebody says Modi ji is best. Right. So that is personal view. Personal view. I think largely people will agree that Mahatma Gandhi is best. Most of the people will agree. Right. And when you say best, right. Suddenly, why I wrote that? Because certainly they will be considered better than them. Right. If you say best, better, right. You can take, let's say, good or average also you can write. Right. So, the question is that how we come to know? Some people will not agree. some people will, let's say some people do not agree. Some people do not agree. Most people agree. Most people agree. So, why? This is the question comes, why? Read. So, some people will have their some basis. They will have also their basis. Read. Basis. Basis means on what basis, on what logic, on what grounds, let's say you say that, okay, yes, this is how you accept, and some people disagree. So, the basis, what you are talking, this. So, this basis will be considered largely, let's say that, ki ethics. And this basis will be considered as morality. Right. So, the basis on which we say, let's take in general, this is called theoretical ethics. Theoretical ethics means there will be theoretical explanation, there will be philosophies which will be logicking it that why this person is better and that person is good. So you will have some logic, basis is called logic. Logic, this logic is relative and this logic is universal, but it is not majority minority. Majority people suppose, so majority people can view, and majority people if in suppose in one society if you go, so majority people can say no, Modi ji is better, because society has different groups, different community. So in some group, let's say if you go, so many people will say majority of people will come that Modi is better. So it is not about majority minority. The basis on which you say something as good, that should be rational. That should be rational. That should be objective. That should be based on logic. And when most of the people have that rationality, or they logic it, so that is how you say as universal, right? And that is how you have universally accepted principles. So there are universally accepted principles, and that is how ethics deals with. So this ethics is all about all these issues. It will also deal with moral aspect, moral view also. It will deal also issues of when the two people fight, so it becomes issue. When two groups fight, one says, no, Modi is best. They say, no, Gandhi is best. Right. And there is a tussle between both. It is issue. Right. So this becomes ethical issue, unresolved issue. Right. This is how. So what I wanted to tell, let's say that by this example, that the paper that we are going to deal especially about theoretical ethics. So this theoretical ethics is about human behavior. They are all human, and one trait we compared of human behavior, that is called, so human has human behavior, and in this human behavior we have compared one quality called leadership. Right. So human has human behavior, and one aspect of human behavior is called leadership, and that leadership we have compared with different leaders. Right. And then we are trying to, let's say that, say the basis on which we say, so you have already certain understanding in your mind, and on the basis of whatever in your mind you are logicking, and you are saying that this leader is better, this leader is best, this leader is good. It means your mind already has certain understanding of what is good, what is bad, what is right, what is wrong. Isn't it? Already your mind has certain basis of thinking. So how that mind, your mind or the knowledge, whatever you have, which think that what is good, what is bad, what is right. So whether the logic you give from your own knowledge, so whether it is logical, whether it is rational, this is how we'll try to, let's say, deal in this paper. And that will also refine your knowledge. That will also refine your understanding. So this is how, although still less, a person can have his own personal view on morality. Whenever you have your personal view, it is more about morality. And when you have a view which is universally accepted rationally, so that is ethics. Right. And how it happens, why it happens, that is what we have to study in ethics, let's say that, paper. So when we take, let's say, ethics, in brief I tell, then I will begin it. Ethics. So ethics deals with human behavior. Ethics deals with human behavior. What it, now, the question is, what of human behavior? What of human behavior? So, it deals with character. Conduct. Character and conduct. Of what character and conduct? Right. Wrong, bad, good, acceptable, rejectable, right. So ethics basically deals with human behavior, right. Human behavior of character and conduct, right. Of what character and conduct? So which character is good, which character is bad, right. Which behavior is good, which behavior is bad, which behavior is right, which behavior is wrong, right. This, so this, now when, let's say that, why we relate human behavior, because you should know that ethics is derived from a Greek word. Greek term known as ethikos. Right. So ethikos, this is how we say that, or it is also written like this, ethikos. Some book write COS, some book write KOS. Either you can write. It means, right, yes, character. It means manner, it means habit, so literal meaning if you talk about the term ethics, which is derived from the term ethikos, it means call anything which arises out of habit or mannerism or character, right. That's why it is said that ethics deals with human behavior. And then in that human behavior, so it will deal with character, conduct of right, wrong, etc. Now, how we'll come to know that which behavior is right and which behavior is wrong? Right. Then the question will be, how we will come to know which behavior is right and which behavior, how we'll come to know? Right. One is common sense that we use, isn't it? So what we will apply, how we'll come to know? So let's say that one is called common sense. Common sense says it is right. No. Then what second? Right. You would live in a society? No. The society? Norms? Traditions? This will happen. Then we also follow in? Believe in religion? Right. So religious values? Societal norms, religious values. Is there any other value? Law. So since we live in a sovereign territory, so there is a law also. Next. Family. Family. No, education will not end. Any other? Right. We also know about human values. Right. Human values. Is there anything else? Right. No, we'll not talk. On what basis? Common sense. That is how we can take. Right. Culture. Culture, societal norms, tradition, culture. We can take. Sacrament. Speak loudly, I'm not able to understand. Right. Sanskar. I think religion will take. Socialization, you want to tell? Right. Human values will take care of that. Right. Any other we can have? Right. Basically, let's say that okay, you will tell on all these bases. Right. Still, there can be some other bases. We are not saying ki there can be caste, community, religion, etc. Right. There can be many other aspects, let's say, but largely you will say something, right? Right and wrong, so we have not still written. Now let's say that these things, whatever you are saying, all these things will be, let's say that, studied by ethics. Right, ethics. These are all acceptable practice. But there is one more practice that is called ethics, or it is we say as right normative ethics, or we say as right theories of ethics. Means let's say that common sense based, we can say, on the basis of your individual, etc. understanding, this is right or wrong, society you can say, religion you can say, law, family values, human values, all these things you can say. But still it may not be rational. Right. It may not be still based on logic. Still there can be biasness. Or it can favor to some people, it can disfavor to some other people. So, these all, let's say that you value, this, whether you talk all these things, either ethics will try to scrutinize these values, or it will, let's say that simply you can say that there is theory, I can add here also theories of ethics. So ethics will not talk, means here in this paper will not talk something right or wrong on the basis of religion, on the basis of common sense, on the basis of society, on the basis of law, on the basis of family values, we will say something as right or wrong in this paper, means in the field of ethics, on the basis of what the theories of ethics say. But certainly, let's say they will not be rejected, right? They will not also be rejected. Why? Because they will also have positive aspects. They can have also positive aspects. So, a person can be belonging to a particular religion, but a person may believe in human values. A person can believe in forgiveness. A person can believe in, let's say, universality. So, a person can follow a particular religion, at the same time he can believe in universal values. So, that is how you can say that he is religious also and ethical also. But some people follow religion and you know that they are more religious than universal values. For them, religion is more important than values. Culture is more important than values. And you can see whatever the religious conflicts happening different places are inter-caste marriage and you know honor killing. So, this is how it conflicts. So, why it is wrong? Suppose somebody recently in southern India, in Hyderabad or Telangana it happened. Right, so there was inter-caste affair and boy was chopped. So, boy was chopped. Right, so whether it is right or wrong? On what basis you will say it is right? On what basis you will say it is wrong? Right, some issues may not be very complex, very simple to decide. But some issues are very complex. For instance, love jihad, Kerala issue, two, let's say one couple. How can you test it is a true marriage? How can you test it is a true love? Right. Can you test it? Can you give any proof for that? Right. We cannot give any proof. And suppose divorce happened tomorrow? Sorry to say that. Right. Let's take hypothetically. So those people who are saying it is not based on true love, they will say, I was saying. Right. We were saying it is not true love. It means wherever divorce happened, it is not a true love. Does it mean? No. Because many people have divorced. So there can be some complex issues where, let's say that your test of ethical understanding come into help. Knowledge of ethical understanding come into help. Law will not help you. Society will not help you. Social values will not help you. Religious values will not help you. You will have to have certain theoretical aspect of ethics. And that will help you. Right. And that is how theories of ethics are considered above all such bases. Although they are at the same time, we'll say they are also important. Right. But when you talk, the theories when we'll talk, the theories of ethics will give you ethical principles, and those ethical principles will be above all these principles. Right. It means they will be more universal. Right. And they can be more social, relative. Social relative means they are largely followed in a particular society. The family value is that in this family never ever, let's say that any marriage has happened in inter-caste. This is a family value. But if you go to Western society, there is no caste. Right. There may be inter-country marriage, not inter-caste. Right. So their value may be different, intersect. There can be issue of intersect, not inter-caste. So family value can be, let's say, value in our country, but it may not be a value in their country. So that is what ethics, let's say that. So when we say ethics deals with very simple way, it deals with human behavior. And when it deals with human behaviors, then what aspect of human behavior? Its character and conduct. In that, right and wrong. How you come to know what is right and wrong? So we come to know, no doubt, by all these things. But in this paper, we'll talk about theories of ethics. Right. And they will give their theories which will also have problems. Don't think that their theories will be sound. Right? Their theories will not have any problem. No. Their theories will also have problem. Why? We are dealing with human behavior. First. Second, human behavior is fully not known. Third, we are yet to understand human behavior. Can we say? We still do not understand full aspect of human behavior, whole aspect of human behavior. How can you understand? For instance, today your landlord, so he may be, let's say, having a bhandara today. So you think that he is a very big-hearted person. Right. And tomorrow he has given you notice. Vacate your house. Then you try to find why he has given this notice. He want to increase rent, hike rent, isn't it? वो भी 10% नहीं चाहता है, वो 20% भी नहीं चाहता है, सीधा 40% चाहता है. ऐसा होता है. Now how you will judge his behavior? Today he is having bhandara. You also enjoyed it, and he is a good fellow, serving to people also. And tomorrow he is serving you notice. Right? So you cannot know human behavior, let's say that. It is very difficult to understand human behavior. Right? How human behavior? So today, let's say that, you promise many things, isn't it? I will be honest, etc. Interview mein pucha jayega, to bahut bada bada value bologe aap. Right? If they ask, how can you be honest? This nowadays they ask in interview, so you will say, yes, I will be honest because I am honest. Right. But let's say that one IPS officer, so he has given his notice for voluntary retirement. He completes 50 years. Many such examples you can find. What has happened? So wherever he gives, let's say that his report, etc., he was posted in one place and he, let's say, found lots of corruption going on. Therefore, he prepared a report and sent to the government that these people action should be taken because there is a serious issues of corruption. What was happened? He was transferred. Then second time again, the place he is transferred, again he did the same thing. This time inquiry is ordered against him. Right. And it may be happening for many years. He is the officer who also investigated Sohrabuddin encounter case. Now he is giving a notice for voluntary retirement after completing 50 years. Right. Why? So he may be saying, now enough is enough. Now he does not want to fight further. Right. He is surrendering, giving in. But when he may have appeared in interview, he may have told, no, I will withstand all challenges. Human behavior, we are saying. My motive is not to highlight his grievance and etc. I gave a different example of human behavior where you find it, it is very difficult to explain human behavior. Then Himanshu Rai, another IPS officer, a brave IPS officer who, let's say, that headed ATS of Maharashtra, and he commits suicide. Right. Human behavior. We are still not going in the issues of those behavior. Just we are saying you human behavior. I gave example of landlord and I gave example of civil servant. Right. And you can take other example. So since the human behavior is not fully known, even if the theories, what they will talk, they will not be also fully, completely accepted. But we have to know them. We have to understand them. Right? This is how. You will not say in first place, they have problem. First, you have to understand them. Right? And you have to apply them, even if they have some problem. So, first we'll tell you that what are those theories, etc. Then we'll come back again to this ethics. And that is how, let's say, that ethics will deal with, or the theories of ethics will deal with, and that is how there are different branches of ethics. Right. Different branches of ethics, let's say normative ethics. So normative ethics will set ethical principles on the basis of certain philosophy. And let's say that applied ethics will try to study in applied situations, society, right, family, etc. And they will find ki what how people follow values and what are the issues. Right. Similarly, you have, let's say, the descriptive ethics. It will try to analyze. It means simply will tell that ethics is a field. The way you have philosophy as a field, right, philosophy as a discipline. Similarly, ethics is also a discipline. Ethics is not just a term. Ethics is not only a concept. Right. Ethics is also a normative science field. Or the way you have philosophy as a subject, anthropology as a subject. Similarly, ethics is also a subject. And what subject does? The main aspect of any subject is to propound theories, principles, isn't it? So in anthropology, you may have theory. Who has anthropology optional? Right. So there will be theoretical explanation. Right. This is how. So there will be theoretical explanation. This is how ethics will also do for theoretical explanation. Right. Then any optional subject deal with applied also. Right. Generally we say paper second is applied and paper one is theory. Mota moti philosophy if you apply means general principle. Right. So this is how theory, ethics is also theory. So principles you have to learn. And after learning the principles, rest 6 chapter or 5 chapter you have to apply. In first chapter, ethics will learn as a theory, and the rest other such chapters, let's say that we have beat attitude, ethics and attitude is also linked, ethics and aptitude is also linked, ethics, emotional intelligence, already they have asked the question, discuss how emotional intelligence will help in ethical conduct. That is a question in 2013. So means ethics and emotional intelligence can also be linked, and ethics and civil service, you know already. No. So there is a strong link between ethics and civil service, and 2 chapters you have for that. Right. Probity in governance and ethics, civil service values. That will be the application part. And that's why theory section is important. Right. So let's take what are those theories in this. Normative theories of ethics. these are four schools which you should know. First is called the Greek philosophy. So basically, this is Greek philosophy. Which they will emphasize on virtue of a person. Means, I will tell shortly what they are talking. Then another important thing is called deontology, or you say Kantian philosophy. It is synonymous whether we talk about deontology or Kantian. So Kant, Immanuel Kant, is one of the biggest philosophers. So this is how synonymous. Teleological, when we talk, and consequentialist, let's say that. So in that we can have three such schools. One is called utilitarian, led by Bentham and J.S. Mill. Then contractarians. There are two schools in contractarians. One is called Thomas Hobbes, John Locke, and Rousseau. And that is the early contractarian. The recent contemporary contractarian we have is called John Rawls, Theory of Justice, which they asked in 2016. So they have asked this. They have asked Kant, and they have asked Aristotle. It means ki those who have not been asked, they will be asked, or they will not also be asked. Right. So let's say that it is a expected question. Today, tomorrow, they can ask. Right. It is also expected ki when they will ask this. Right. And then, or there can be a repeat, because he is a very popular thinker, John Rawls, Theory of Justice. So since he is a very popular thinker, so there can be a repeat of that, and that is how we will be expecting. Now, just in brief, we will tell you okay, what exactly they are talking about, right? What, how they will say something right and wrong. So the question we take is that ethics deals with human behavior. In that human behavior, right, character means ki what is a good behavior, what is a bad behavior. In day-to-day life, you have lots of fight in family, isn't it? On good and bad? No. So some people may go and justify junk food is good for health. Right. So how you justify? I eat at least once in a week. No, I don't eat regularly. But I exercise also. So if you take good, bad, right, wrong, day-to-day basis, in the family itself there is a tussle. There is itself fight. So there is also fight. What is a good way to prepare this examination? What is good optional? There is no good optional. There is only optional. So the question is that good. Good is added, let's say that. So whatever the object you have in our society, that object, any object, object means not, let's say, object is a term which is used to refer anything in our society. Right. So any object we have, there is, let's say, prefix before that object, good and bad, right and wrong. Right. And if you go to beyond that, it is also, let's say, if you have many good people, then you have to select better one. Right. Right. All people appearing in this examination, so they are good people. Then better qualify. Right. And the best qualify finally. But still there can be some people who may not be best. They qualified. So the question is how you will distinguish good, better, best when many people are good. But that is still we are not talking. So we took this, let's say, that question. How they will, let's say that something is right or wrong. Right. How this philosophy will tell. So I have to take another analogy, means another way to tell it. So let's take read philosophies. Read philosophy's main premise or principle. Philosophy, main premise, principle, this you can say, and we can give also explanation. If you take this virtue ethics, right, it's a human character. Itself basis for good behavior. So it will say that human character itself is a basis for good behavior. Right. So human character is itself, and this character should be virtuous. If you have a virtuous character, so you can behave good, can we say? So they will not focus on action, which action is right or wrong. No. They focus before action. Right. They focus before action. So when you say ethics is about human behavior, it is, when we say human behaviors, it is also about human. How human behavior will be known? When human acts. And basically we judge, what we judge? This, whether it is right or wrong. So we are judging action. We are not judging human. We are judging his action. So ethics will judge human action, not human. So no matter how good person you are, many people you say that, but it does not appear. Dikhta to nahi hai. Right. Many people say that. You can be a good fellow, but how other people will know? Right. How the interview board will know that you are a good person? You have to tell. Right. You have to tell, let's say that, in that 15 minutes they will judge you. If they fail to judge, then you know what happens. So, right or wrong, we judge on the basis of human action. That's why in newspaper, many people have, let's say, spoken something. On that basis, there is a debate. You should have not spoken, you must have spoken, he is a right person, he is a wrong person. You are not judging that person, you are judging his. Like yesterday, Nasiruddin Shah wrote something on, let's say that, right, ki Virat Kohli. So you are not judging him, you are judging his action. But they will not judge human action. They will judge the human. Right. So let's say that human. So let's say that the human who has acted. And that they will say, if this human is virtuous, if human is virtuous, this human will have good action. Right. And therefore their emphasis is on human character. Right. And they will give four features of that human. Who is a virtuous person? The virtuous person is who has courage. Right. The person who has courage. Then a person who has temperance. Right. A person who has justice, and a person who has wisdom, Neither we have. Do we have? Right. So, courage to speak your mind. But UP police ke log to bol nahi rahe. Right. This is how. So, courage to speak your mind. If there is truth, so you speak truth. If there is lies, so you should speak lie. That is called courage. No, courage was that ki Bhagat Singh sacrificed his life. Courage is also that ki we run away. Ramdev Baba run away from protest. So how we will distinguish? Although he is a yoga teacher, so he must be internally very strong. Right, sarcastically take it, not seriously. Right, so courage, let's say that. The courage do we have? Temperance called emotional control. Control on your emotions. Do we have control on emotions? Right. So control on emotions. Can you control, regulate your emotions? Justice is fairness. Do you have sense of fairness? Right. This is how. And the last is called wisdom. Wisdom is the highest level of knowledge in human, which is compared with enlightenment. Or in Indian philosophy, nirvana. Liberation. Right. So this is how they say that. Ab jiske paas four quality hoga, to vaise hi human action, right? Is it? Anyhow, so what they will say is that if a human has good character, that's why there will be good action. Is it relevant? True? Acceptable? Is it acceptable? Overwhelmingly acceptable. इसलिए तो इंटरव्यू वाला आपका इंटरव्यू ले रहा है क्यों वो जानना चाहता है विच काइंड ऑफ ह्यूमन यू आर रेड ऑलरेडी यू हैव शोन योर इंटेलिजेंस इन मेन एग्जामिनेशन तो दे आर टेस्टिंग योर कैरेक्टर राइट ऑल इंपॉर्टेंट पोजिशंस हैव क्वालिफिकेशन ऑफ कैरेक्टर मेंशन नॉन मेंशन Right. So it will be mentioned also, not mentioned also. Anyone cannot be judged. Right. By default, forget about it, but anyone cannot be judged. Anyone cannot become CVC. It is mentioned impeccable integrity. Right. Anyone cannot become judge. And anyone cannot remain in office when character is lost. Right. It is true. Right, it is true, we'll tell in detail, let me tell in short. Detail will take, so this is how. So it means, let's say one standard now you come to know of right and wrong. The one standard of right and wrong is quality of human. Right, quality of human character. Right, and on the basis of that, many a time you say that. If he has said, so it is acceptable. Right. Or if he has said, so he must have said something right. Right. This is how it is. So you have blind faith in some people. Right. Blind faith in some people you have. Why? Because of character. So this, then let's take another standard. So it is one such standard. Second standard we'll talk is called deontology. Or can't. Right. Can't or deontology. Right. Deonto, we'll tell in detail, but let here talk about selflessness as basis for human conduct. Means universal universal right values, and second is called You may not understand, but let's say his philosophy say that right and wrong we can say of human conduct on the basis of selflessness. Selflessness in the sense that whether his action should be end in itself, motive of this human action. So what is the motive of human action? Whether the motive of human action is to achieve some end, or the human action in itself is an end. So that should become basis to judge. That is, in simple way, whether there is a selfless motive behind human action, or there is certain motive behind human action. If selflessness is not the basis behind that action, so that action will not be considered ethical. Then, how will know it? Let's say what we talk about, we gave example of Nasiruddin Shah. Now he has posted, so whether he has posted because he wanted to post, or he has some ulterior motive. So whether there has been any such motive behind that human action, if there is any motive behind their action, except selflessness, so that human action will not be considered right. That will be considered wrong. Means he will be against any human action which should become a means, and by that you want to achieve any end. So whenever you bring means and ends relation, so he will reject it. Means, ends. Means and ends should be the same. Right. There should not be a continuum, and means should precede end, and this is how you want to work on this means to achieve this end. Both should be the same, means human action should be based on selfless motive. The only motive which is selfish that can make your action end in itself, otherwise there will always be means and ends. Difficult to understand? If you do not understand, so don't worry, it is the first class of it. Right. We are not still teaching Kantian philosophy in detail. If you suppose do not understand, so you should not understand. Right. Right. We have to tell in brief, we want to give the idea of the theoretical ethics, idea of what is, let's say that, ethics theory. And this idea we are trying to give, will take you one class on Kant. One class. Right. It will take on every philosophy, will take almost one class, even more than that. So you should not worry. It will explain in threadbare details. But what we are trying to say is, let's take example. Aapne kisi ko help kiya hoga? Yes. So when you help somebody, to aap kya sochte ho? Ki jisko main help kar raha hu, wo to aapke, he should be a bit thankful to you. Obliged to you also, isn't it? So, if you help some people, so what do you think? At least he should respect me, isn't it? Appreciate, and he should have some moral obligation also. Especially when you help your poor fellows, housemaid, servant, isn't it? So you want that they should be morally obliged. और किसी दिन आपके हाउसमेट ने यह बोल दिया आपसे कि यू आर हेल्पिंग बिकॉज ऑफ योर बेनिफिट, सो व्हाई आई शुड बी मोरली ऑब्लाइज्ड टू यू, इजंट इट? रिलीजन टीचेज चैरिटी, तो वो बोलेगी रिलीजन, यू आर गिविंग मी बिकॉज ऑफ योर रिलीजन, तो यू आर डूइंग योर रिलीजियस ड्यूटी, तो व्हाई आई शुड बी मोरली ऑब्लाइज्ड, तो यू फील हर्ट. When you are helping a person and you want that he should be morally obliged, so this is means and ends. No, it is means and ends. Right. If many people are doing charity to earn some social prestige in society, the means and ends. Can you find some people who do, let's say that charity, but without getting noticed. So there will not be mean silence. He is helping for the sake of helping. Right. So when you want to seek a return, right, no. Parents also want to seek a return. So they upbring you so that you can help in their old age. Means and ends. So Kant is wrong or right? So you can criticize him. Right. Anyhow, so the question what he is talking is, basically let's say there is a link between what you say means and ends, since we talk, and let's say that many a time. So whether you want to be an honest civil servant so that ki you can serve to people, or you want to be honest and so that you can get promotion. Right. Whether you want to do good work so that you can get promotion, or you want to do good work because you want to do that. Isn't it? You want to join civil service to get power, prestige, no doubt. Right. Or you want to become civil servant as you want to. Right. He will be very different type of thinker. He is the highest, very lofty thinker of, let's say, among all thinkers, which will set very highest level of conditions for human behavior. Right. Which will teach you later on. So this is one. Now, whether this action is selfless or this action has some motive, that will become basis to judge ki whether action is right or action is wrong. So whether you want to name some cities because of political benefit, or you want to name because of right, culture, right, you can distinguish. Right, this is all. So that is what he talks, means selfless and selfishness. This is how. So selflessness and selfishness become basis to judge in case of Kant. Right?
By that logic, no action is fully selfless.
Yes, but some actions are fully selfless. Right. Like, why you want to be a good person? It makes you feel happy, right? This is how it is. So there is a means and ends, right? The question is, some people will say that, okay, I want to be selfless because I want to be in that. This is what I want to be, right? So some people will say that, okay, I want to be a good person because I want to be. Right. Not that I am deriving happiness or I am deriving, let's say, this and that. Right. This. So when, let's say, that you have this kind of thinking, that is how there will be no means and end. Yes, there is means and end, and that is also a philosophy. But some human action should not have means and ends. Right. Gita philosophy also talk about dutifulness, nishkam karma. Right. Why you should do niskam karma? Because this is your duty. So as a human, it is your duty to be selfless. Why you should be selfless? You don't need to have any basis to justify. As a human, you should be selfless, and this is how the justification. You don't need to have any other things to justify why you should be selfless. Right. And this will be, let's say, that basis to tell. Why? Dekho, the day you will have some basis for justification, the basis keep changing. And therefore, any human action can be justified. Then any human action you can go on justifying, because you have to give good logic to justify. Right. This. So, that is how he will be talking about. Let's take next called teleology. Why we say deonto? Basically, deonto means. That's why we say deontology. I will tell when we'll take separately, so I will tell all these details. Then we have teleology or consequence list. So teleology or consequentialist. Right. In this we'll take one by one school. So we'll take, let's say, utilitarian. So utilitarian will talk about, right, consequence of human action. Should be good, means and ends, and ends should be better than means. This is most of the time you follow. So consequence of the human actions, since consequence, that is why we say consequentialist. Teleology means end. So teleo means end, that is how we say end philosophy. That's why we say teleology or consequentialist. Within utilitarian, they will say that if end is well, so all is well. No, end is well, so all is well. Now, this human action, if this human action is right and wrong on the basis of its consequence. Right. The human action is right on the basis of consequence, isn't it? So, if outcome of the human action is good, that is called as ethical human action. And that is how most of the time we see. Right. So, most of the time you want to have good consequence of human action. Good result. So we want result. No, this is a society, result-oriented society. The administration also want result, business also want result. So wherever you have the philosophy of we want result, do whatever you want to do. Right. So in administration, Yogiji will say, do whatever you want to do, but I want result. Gokasi band hona chahiye. Right. Take sarcastically. Right. So basically, let's say that when he says that do whatever you want to do, I want result. Right. It means he does not care, means not only he, utilitarian does not care, means they want action which results into good end. Business mein bhi aapko yehi bola jayega. So when you join any business, they will say, we want result. Do whatever you want to do. Right. So this is a major philosophy, let's say that. So human action will be also judged on the basis of consequence. Outcome of human action. Right. This. That's why burger gives you test, good outcome, isn't it? So utilitarian philosophy, eat, drink, make merry. Right. This is utilitarian philosophy. Charvak philosophy also, you know. Right. So, eat, drink, make merry. Khao, piyo, khush raho. Right. This is how it is. So, utilitarian philosophy. Because good consequence is good. Enjoy life. But our philosophy teaches sacrifice. Bolta hai, fasting karo. Right. This is how. So fasting and enjoying, both are contradictory, but we'll take later on, right? Utilitarian is one philosophy. Now let's take second philosophy. Contract. Say contractarian. So contractarian is derived from contract. Right. Or contract also become basis for your conduct? No, you enter lots of contract. Right. Job may be contract hota hai. Right. So contract become basis for your conduct. So when you join any job, so they will have a contract. No, they will sign a bond also. So suppose there is a contract that if you leave this job, so you have to pay this bond money. So then you have to give. It is not unethical. And suppose there is no contract and then they say, this is not right. So contract, let's say society has also lots of agreement. Society enters many agreements. Let's say international, national, other such things happen. Right. So many agreements we enter, and many a times it is against agreement. Right. There is also alliance, grand alliance. They also have common minimum program. Right. That is also a contract. But this contract, they are not talking, let's say, although it is applied, they are talking social contract. Right. So contract means social. Have you heard social contract? Yes. Social contract is a contract which became basis for emergence of this type of state. Right. State emerged. Right. State, it has territory, it has it is sovereign. Right. So state is how state must function. It is functioning on the basis of social contract. Right. Now human action should be on the basis of social contract. Ab human ke liye to social contract ho gaya nahi. So this social contract is largely for action of state. This we were talking about human action. Right. But this is for largely action of state. How state must act on the basis of social contract. Right. This, or if you apply to people, so people, this human action will be on the basis of consensus, agreement. So human action should be on the basis of consensus, agreement. What is consensus and agreement? The social norms. Social norms are on the basis of informal agreement. That's why there is a social norm. The social norm in the society is on the basis of informal agreement. You accept, as long as you accept, you have consensus. So, in society it can be applied, but largely they are talking not about human, they are talking about state, social contract, human action, state action. Therefore, Hobbes' philosophy will be more applied to about state and other such aspects. And human action should also be on the basis of certain contract between two or more individuals. And if the action is honoring that contract, so it is considered ethical. And if it is not honoring that contract, it will not be considered ethical. Man is a social animal. Marriage is a social contract. Yes. So marriage is a social contract, isn't it? And that is how you should behave as per that. So your action should be on that basis, contract. But basically, let's say that they will not talk about marriage, they will not talk about society, etc. Right. This contractarian philosophy is for state. And how state must act. Because human action can be of different category. Human action can be as a human action can be as a civil servant, human action can be as a government, human action can be as a corporate. So the human action can also be categorized into different aspects. This, and the third one, let's talk, the third I will write here. If I write third one, contractarian by John Rawls. He is also a contractarian, but what he talks? Justice. What we'll talk? Fairness. Fairness as basis. So fairness as basis. How fairness as basis will be? Right. What is fair? What is fair? Right. So what is fair? So he will give some principle, let's say that. Equality principle. And differential principle. Equality principle, differential principle. Right. And if you act on that principles, so then human action will be considered ethical. So it means this human action, let's say that, so you have virtue as quality of human. It should be selfless. It should be fair. It should be based on contract. Right. Good outcome. Right. This is how we are talking. So human action should be, now you can have all those, let's say, theories which are talking. So human action, let's say human should have a virtuous quality. Human action should be selfless. It should be fair. It should be based on contract, means consensus, agreement, whatever you can tell. Right. And there should be good outcome plus others. Others means we can use also Gita philosophy, we can use Mahabharata, we can use Ramarajya, right, Ramayana, etc., Buddhism, Jainism, Tirukul, etc. It is not that we will be teaching our ethics, we will be taking only this. There will be also some other basis also. Right, human action. So, human action to get characterized as ethical, there are theoretical explanations, and irrespective of what is your view, you have to conform to their view. Right? This. So whether you agree, you disagree, first you have to understand them, what they are talking, and second that, let's say you have to agree what they are talking. Even if you don't, let's say, accept or reject whatever, that will be your moral values, moral understanding. Right. And that is what, let's say, that we have to deal on these theories and principles. And they will set their those theories and principles. So there is no one way. It means we don't have one way to judge any human action as right or wrong. Right. Different situations will demand different approach of philosophy. And at times we can logic all these things. At times you can take one or two, and this is how we can apply. For instance, when you deal with business sector, so we largely, business sector is based on utilitarian philosophy. When you talk about human life, the human life should be based on selfless philosophy. Right. Humans should be selfless. And it is not only Kant who talks about selflessness. Right. It will be also about Gita philosophy. It will be also by Buddha. It will be also by Vivekananda. All of them will talk about selflessness. Or selflessness as basis for human. So do we have selfless, which is very difficult to achieve? That is how people try to be selfless towards end of life, isn't it? They will try to give up everything. Towards end of life, you want to be selfless. After, let's say, achieving all those selfish aspects in life. So, let's take now understanding ethics. Great. Understanding ethics, but before that, let me tell that apart from normative ethics, we told you normative ethics theories. Then I will take this topic. Apart from that, we have also other, right. ethical perspectives. One we say as feminist perspective. We say as feminist ethics or care ethics. Then we have applied ethics. In applied ethics, we have professional ethics. Bioethics, medical ethics, media ethics, sport ethics, ethics in civil services. Yes, environmental ethics. It means when we were talking about human action, so that theoretical explanation. Theoretical principles we have applied. This is normative. Because, let's say, human action is general. Now, this human action will be in the context of family, society, or it can be organization. So basically, human is acting either in a family or in a society or in any organizational context. Right. So in any organizational context, it can be government, organization can be any, so etc. So human is not acting, let's say that in vacuum, in open environment, free, in, let's say, on Himalaya. Right. Human will act in any society. Let's say this class. Class is also one such place. The human action in class, isn't it? So if somebody starts taking breakfast, isn't it? So one day it is acceptable. But if it becomes a daily routine, so although it will not be rejected, but the people sitting behind him or beside him, they may not feel good. They will also feel like eating. The question is, let's say that human behavior. Now, let's say human behavior in a given situation. The early morning in park, so you can go for jogging. Right. But you should not go for jogging in midday, afternoon. Right. Either you jog in morning or evening. If you jog at odd times, let's say that, so this is not the right human action. So human is acting not in a vacuum. Human is acting either in family, society, any such context. And when human is acting in any such context, that is what we say applied. So applied ethics will also be applied. Means ethics of that context will also be applied apart from this normative theory. Right. This. So human, let's say now you as a human, you are a civil servant. So you have to follow civil service values more than any values. So you have to follow civil service values, and therefore your liberty and freedom will be regulated. Right. Your liberty and freedom will be regulated. Let's take you as a human being. So you as a civil service aspirant, so you are free to talk on Twitter, Facebook, etc., isn't it? You talk very free. Suppose tomorrow you qualify, become a civil servant. Now you will not have the same freedom. So you will not have the same freedom. Now you say, no, I will have the same freedom. Suppose you say, no, I will have the same freedom. So then you are breaching this, you are breaching this, and perhaps you can be, let's say, disciplinary action can also be taken. So a human is, let's say that, a human can be son, a human can be father, a human can be daughter, a human can be mother, a human can be civil servant, doctor, let's say lawyer, professional, judge, right? Human will act in different capacity. And since human will act in different capacity, first that capacity related ethics will apply. And then these principles will also be applied. For instance, media. Media ethics. Media role is to give free and fair news. In security disturb areas, they can give whatever they observe. That will not be liked by security forces. It will not be liked by security forces. Media role is to report, and somebody needs help, so you can criticize him also. He should have given help, not report. Why? Because you are seeing from this perspective. You are not seeing from this perspective. So unless you have knowledge of media ethics also, media values also, you will give more preference to security forces over media. Media should not report anything adverse in disturbed area against security forces. Many people will say yes. They should support security forces. Is it? What do you think? Should they support? And they should write whatever they observe. Right, no view, you don't have any view. Let's take a simple question. Forget about it. Doctor. Whether doctor should give treatment to. Next slides. Should doctor give treatment to next slides? Yes. And for that treatment, should he be punished? No. Why he should not be punished? Yes? It is not humanity, etc. Look, doctor, applied ethics, medical ethics. Doctor main role is to save life, irrespective of who the person is. Ab wo chahe chori kyun ho, sorry to say that, means whether person is thief, person is dacoit, person is terrorist, person is naxalite. Doctor role is to save. Doctor role is not to work as a security personnel and fight for security. For that you have security personnel. For that you have military, for that you have paramilitary, for that you have all those forces. Doctor has no role. It can on a special request help you. But doctor role in society is to save life of people. It means ki applied ethics become many a time more important than what general ethics can talk, we were talking about. So that you have to also take into consideration, because human action is in different context. You are behaving in the context of your environment, so environment ethics will come. And then firecrackers, environment ethics. So whether now religious values, firecracker, environment ethics, what should be done? Green crackers? No. And without cracker, no Diwali. So human behavior, how will let's analyze. So there will be, this is how you should know that. So apart from normative ethics theory we told, we will tell you in brief also about them. In fact, environment ethics, already they have asked question in 2015. So they have asked in 2015, first question. The first a question related to environment ethics. Civil service already we have in the syllabus itself. Sports, media, bio, professional ethics also they have asked. When they ask competence,
that is related to professional ethics, we have been inspecting also question. From that org, a case study was asked this year on tax and doctor. So doctor, now whether tax official should go for, or doctor should be allowed to go and allow to do his treatment, etc. So you have knowledge, you should have knowledge about this. So certain aspect of knowledge is also required in this area, so we'll take all these things. So this is what about your certain aspects of, or all aspects of theoretical ethics in brief. Now we will talk about understanding ethics. Let's. Yes. Betting is allowed in some situation, in some sports, but not in all sports. There is logic also for that, right? So understanding ethics. What is to understand? We have already talked, isn't it? But still you have to understand. So basically let's say that ethics. Human behavior, conduct, deliberate human conduct. We'll give you some theoretical aspect that is not adequate that we told. That is just for your understanding. It deals with human behavior, etc. There is still certain theoretical explanation about different aspects of human behavior. So human, now ethics deals with human behavior and conduct, but it does not deal with all human behavior and conduct. It deals with deliberate human conduct. Right. It will deal with deliberate human conduct. What is deliberate human conduct? So we'll explain. I'm giving just equation. So there are three conditions for deliberate human conduct. Right. Knowledge, voluntariness, and free will. Then once action is deliberate, we move further. So ethics deals with human behavior. Now in human behavior, it deals with deliberate human conduct. Right. Now once conduct is deliberate, so the deliberate human conduct is judged ethical. It is judged ethical on the basis of, there are further conditions. Right, so there are further conditions. Purpose of human action, circumstances, right, consequences. Right. Purpose, circumstances, consequences. Right. And normative ethical theories plus other. Can be human values, universal values, etc. Means ethics will not deal with any human behavior. ethics will deal with only deliberate human behavior. This is for your knowledge, right? Now let me say that. Suppose there is a child, a six-year-old child, right? Child is behaving something. Child, when child behaves wrong, child is slapped in Indian condition, right? Why you are slapping? You say it is wrong. Do we say it is wrong? Right. What do we say? It is not good. Right. Do you think that the child has a moral sense? Child does not have a moral sense. Right. Child is yet does not have understanding of what is right and what is wrong. But you are expecting from a child a moral sense. Or rather, you are training the child, teaching the child. Right. But we go beyond that teaching also. Some children are very naughty, so family members are very worried. In fact, pure mohalle mein, they talk only about that child. Bade hoke kya karega, chota hai to aisa hai. Are bade hoke change ho jayega. Right. This is how it is. But you think that, you know, child behavior will remain static. Right. This is a wrong understanding. Right. It is a wrong understanding. If a child is naughty in childhood, so he will be like that. Right. That is why you have to understand these things. The process. So this, now let's take that ki Sole movie you may have watched, no doubt. And when there is the Viru and Jay go to that locality, and what was his name, that police officer? Thakur. He had both hands, let's say that, chopped. Right. And he is not helping. A gun to be picked up, and he cannot. They become angry. Right. And suppose they become angry and they start beating him. Ye to achhi baat hai ki they did not beat. Right. This is agent. So what do you learn from that in ethics sense? Right. You learn that ki his action is right. Or he is not capable of behaving as a normal human being. And therefore his action is not deliberate. Right. This is how it is. So there are some conditions which make human action indeliberate. You cannot behave like a normal human being. So all action will not be subject to scrutiny. This is just for your knowledge understanding. So we'll tell that ki human action, deliberate human action. What is deliberate human actions? We'll explain these things by examples. Plus, you go ahead further and then it will be judged. Already we told these things, right? We have added also, but two more things we are adding. Purpose and circumstances. Now he was saying that ki every time it is not possible to be selfless. Yes, it is not possible to be selfless. Why? Because of circumstances. You be selfless, but can we be selfless? Difficult. Selflessness further will be explained that you should not kill people. Yes, you should not kill people. But in some situation, you have to kill people to save some other people. Is it? Right. Soldiers, when they fight their war, so some they're injured soldiers, they cannot carry and fight. And they know that they may not be saved. To fight for the larger cause, right, they have to kill their own soldier. Right. Circumstances. So you are killing your own soldier, your own brethren, right? But it is a circumstance. But suppose a soldier kills another soldier in normal circumstances. it is a crime. And let's say that the soldier was not, let's say, seriously injured, but deliberately you killed because you wanted to. So then circumstances will not be taken into consideration. Right. Then the purpose will come, consequence will come, and certainly can't will also come. Right. So you can see that there are many permutation combinations, many situations, many factors which affect human behavior. And when we judge human behavior as action, whether right or wrong, so we have to take multiple such calculations into consideration, and then finally we judge any human action as ethical or unethical. Means ki ab let's take example normal. Ab hum log kya karte hain, abhi news incident aaya nahi aur aapne padha nahi ki aapka view aa gaya. Right? Is it? Neither you know circumstances, nor you know purpose, nor you know intention, nor you know consequence. You do not know all these things, and you say that ki this is wrong, this is right. So if you believe and tell that way, it is not rational. What is a rational thinking? The rational thinking is that ki you are aware about all these things. So your mind passes through all of them. And then here you come to say that whether human action is right or wrong, then that human action or your thinking will be considered rational. Right. And we do not follow all these things in day-to-day life. Rather, we say on the basis of common sense. What is common sense? So since bus conductor dress and red said that dress up is appearing to be like a criminal, that's why he murdered a child. Rayan International School. The police arrested on the basis of common sense. Ki he looks like a murderer. Right. And then you arrest him. Right. So it happens, let's say, many a time, isn't it? So kuch logon ka chehra bhi ajeeb tarike ka dikhta hai. Right. So by facial expression also you judge yourself without talking to that person. Whether he is a good person or a bad person. Right. Isn't it? We keep judging. This is how our mind will not stop. Our mind will keep judging any person you see on the basis of face, dress up, etc. without meeting and talking to that person. And some people can bet also, isn't it? It is all not rational thinking. Right. So this is how you have to write. Let's write on this aspect further. I will tell in, let's take in details a bit explaining what they are things. So let's write on this. Right. Ethics deals with human behavior. Ethics deals with human behavior. Human behavior. Human behavior with an aim to achieve summum bonum. Summum bonum, the chief good. By judging right, / wrong, human behavior, on the basis of normative ethical principles. And therefore, ethics is also a field of normative science. Ethics is also a field of normative science. Normative science. normative science, which aim is not only, to know which behavior is right or wrong, which aim is not only to know which behavior is right or wrong, but also, first, to set normative ethical principles, oblique standards, which become basis for judgment. Second, read. Explain the different nature of human action. Next, third. To promote human character, conduct. Promote human character, conduct, so that people can achieve the highest standards of conduct. Known as summum bonum. Summum bonum is highest standard of conduct. Right. Good, better, best. Further light, therefore, ethics is not merely about human behavior. Good and bad aspects. Rather, it is also about promotion of exemplary human behavior. Read. Further, any human conduct is judged as right or wrong on the basis of normative ethical principles, which are also known as established standards. That is, human conducts can be acceptable by people on the basis of their own values, understanding. But to consider any human conduct as ethical, to consider any human conduct as ethical, it must be based on established standards. The established standards are first, normative principles of ethics provided by theories of ethics. Next, deliberate human conduct. Next, determinants of ethics, such as purpose of human action, circumstances. And the next, consequences of human action. Right. So this is more, let's say, academic way to approach. So whatever we told, we have now told in few words. So when we talk about ethics, etc., so we have added one more term called established standard. And second, we talk about summum bonum. See, the ethics is not only about judging which right is good, which right is wrong or bad. It is more than that. It is also about, helping achieve people highest good. So Aristotle will not talk that, yes, you should be a good person. Right. Aristotle will also say that you should be the most virtuous person also. And that's why they will say that wisdom is the highest end of human knowledge. And that's why wisdom was given as the fourth such ethical principle. So they will not talk only about what is right and wrong merely. They will talk more than that. They will also set established principles. Plus, ethics is not only based on that theories. Ethics has also some other, components in which we say as established standard. That is what we are talking, deliberate human conduct and purpose and circumstances, which are known as determinants of ethics as per your syllabus. If you see your syllabus, essence of human action, essence of ethics in human action, determinants of ethics, and consequence. So that is the part of the syllabus. So determinants we consider as purpose and circumstances. Consequence already will tell you, and already we have told partially what is consequence. This, and then we say any, action as ethical. So in simple way, you can say human action as ethical on the basis of established standards or ethical standards. So a human action can be good, but it cannot be ethical. A human action can be considered good as it depends on all those people how they considered. Right. So let's say that a person marries in the same caste, the family will say it is good. Right. The parents will say the son has followed family tradition, good. Right. And when you go for intercaste, family will say that Delhi mein jaake bigad gaya. Right. So this is how it is. Is it? Let's write. Established standards. Let's write. What? Right. Understanding this deliberate human conduct. People can have right. actions people can have actions which can be casual, unintended, or deliberate. Ethics in general deals with only deliberate human conduct.
That is, not all human actions are subject to ethical scrutiny.
Ethical scrutiny. A human action is considered deliberate if it fulfills three conditions. Three conditions. First, knowledge that the person has complete knowledge. About his her action.
Next, voluntariness.
That is, the person is willing to act. The person is willing to act.
Right.
For example, if a person is preparing for civil service, so he has willingness for this. He is not preparing under any pressure. Is it?
Right. Free will. Voluntariness means you are willing to.
Means whatever the action you are doing, you are willing to. This is a general example. So suppose Mr. A is a civil servant, he takes bribe.
Right.
So suppose he takes bribe, so, and he says that, you know, he does not want, but he cannot avoid. We say it. He will say that he does not want, but he cannot avoid. Is it acceptable?
Circumstances.
You have to bring circumstances. Right. This. But I will tell you that ki willingness is also there. Right. Without willingness, how can you take? Right. This is how it is. If you do not have willingness, you don't take it. This is how it is. If you are not willing, so you don't take it. Don't say that you cannot avoid. Right. This. So this is how, let's say, voluntariness. Now knowledge he already has. Right. Knowledge ki it is against conduct rule. He will not say he does not have knowledge. Right. The knowledge he has, there is voluntariness and free will. Free will, let's write also that. Free will is about choice. Free will is about choice. Choice in human action. Choice in human action. That whether person has choices, whether person has choices, alternatives, or there is no choice. There is no choice. Right. Now let's say that, okay, alternatives, what is the free will here? You have the choice to take it, not take it. Right. There is no only choice. Only choice will happen when somebody gives you at gunpoint. Right. Somebody says you take it at gunpoint. So when somebody says at gunpoint, you don't have a choice. Right. But let's say somebody gives, let's say bribe. So you have a choice. Choice means you take, do not take. Right. This is how it is. How can you distinguish it? Different things. Means how can you distinguish between voluntariness and free will? Right. Knowledge you know. So let's take another traditional example. Sorry to give this example. Two examples we'll give, one traditional, one another. Right. Basically in our country. In marriage, let's say that. In marriage, let's say that if you talk girls' marriage, so basically let's say that these things are affected in arranged marriage. Right. Girl, she knows that she is getting married. She does not have voluntariness in many cases. Sorry, she has voluntariness because she is willing to marry. Right. Suppose a girl, so she is willing to get married, she has knowledge to get married, but she does not have free will. In arranged marriage, we are talking. Right. Why she does not have free will? Because choice is by parents. Right. Choice is by parents or choice is by gotra. Right. This is how it is. So that fixed the choice. Right. And it is not movie that you can buy the Panditji. Right. Anyhow. So the let's say that. Now let's say that in marriage there is one ethical issue. Ethical issue is there. Right. So she is not, let's say that, fulfilling her human action means act of marriage is not fulfilling the three conditions. It is not deliberate human action. That's why anything happens in marriage, the parents are blamed. Right. Because it is the action by parents. Right. So in arranged marriage, anything happened wrong, so parents are blamed. And in love marriage, anything happened wrong, so who are blamed? The parents blame them. Right. The deliberate human action shift. Right. This way you can understand the difference. Let's take another example. That suppose it is a disaster-like situation. And when there is even same military example where a soldier has to kill. Right. If you take that circumstances where a soldier has to kill his own, let's say that brethren, and circumstances is there. Knowledge also he knows he is killing. Right. He does not have free will, no choice. Because if he will not kill, they will not kill, perhaps they will have more injuries, more killing. They have to fight against the, let's say that opponent. And voluntariness, he is not willing to kill. He is not willing to kill. Unless he has some ulterior motive, that's a different thing. In general, he is not willing to kill. He has complete knowledge, but he lacks free will. He has no choice. And therefore, that human action is also considered ethical, not unethical. Right. Because of this circumstances. Right. So this will help you in basically case studies, when you will face different case studies. And in case study, there will be certain incident, action, etc. In back of mind, you should have knowledge about ki action also must have three conditions. All actions we cannot say ethical and unethical. We have to take into consideration. So let's write few lines on these aspects. Right. The relevance of the three conditions are that, the relevance of the three conditions are that, the relevance of three conditions are that they help in understanding human action. They help in understanding human action. Human action at finer level. At finer level. That whether human action is deliberate. Deliberate, especially whether a person has choice for action, whether a person has choice for action, or whether a person is willing to act, whether a person is willing to act. For instance, in disaster-like situation, in disaster-like situation, few lives are ignored for the sake of, few lives are ignored for the sake of saving more number of people. More number of people. In this situation, the rescue team lacks free will, although their voluntariness is that they are not willing to ignore, they are not willing to ignore. Changing paragraph. Some human actions are casual. Some human actions are casual. Casual and on the basis of ignorance. On the basis of ignorance. By chance. On the basis of ignorance, by chance, etc. And such human actions are not subject to ethical scrutiny. Such actions are not subject to ethical scrutiny. Right. And generally people are forgiven. Generally people are forgiven for such actions. For such actions. Can we say? When people act by chance, not deliberately, suppose you are going in metro and somebody, let's say, steps at your feet, it can be deliberate also. It can be indeliberate also. Right. Now it is. It depends on you, how you judge it. Right. Suppose it is indeliberate. All, let's say in pushing, passing will happen, such a rush in the metro. It is bound that there will be certain pushing, passing, let's say that. So the question is that how you take it. So you take it just yes, by chance, casually it has happened. But if it is deliberate, then you feel like slapping him. Isn't it? So deliberate human action, human even will not have forgiveness. But there are certain casual actions which happen by slippage, slip of tongue, that is how we say that, by chance it happens, and you seek apology, sorry, etc., and this is how human has also tendency to forgive it. That is how another condition, and the last point, let's write. There are some factors which affect deliberate human action, such as, first, temperament, next habit. Next, pathological state. Next, circumstances. That is, changing power. That is, people due to such factors may not have control on their behavior. Control on their behavior. And therefore, that behavior is also generally not subject to ethical scrutiny. Note, you can write. The utility of deliberate human action is to understand human action in some situations, so that one can have right understanding of nature of human conduct, which becomes basis for judging human conduct as ethical or unethical. So this is what, let's say, today we'll talk tomorrow, but let me tell that today we try to tell you certain reflection of what are those normative theories of ethics, and what, in brief, what they exactly focus and emphasize, which is not adequate to explain. You have to know in details. We'll tell you also in details some of the things. If you have not understood, it is very natural, very obvious. You cannot understand everything in one class, and it is not possible to explain all those things in one class, but we have to give certain understanding. Then we try to focus on about ethics, and ethics deals with human behavior, human conduct. That is also adequate enough to tell and write. If you have to define about ethics, so simply you can say that ethics deals with human behavior, human conduct, in which it differentiates what is right and wrong action, or right action from wrong action. That is also adequate, but not complete. Since we have to also have a completeness sense, adequacy sense, so you have to also deal properly, you have to define in a broad sense properly. That's why we have told it is also a normative science, we say established standard, etc. Then we are now explaining you theoretically ki what exactly is the human conduct or human action. In that we are telling what is a deliberate human action. Although in general you don't have to write or judge and tell in the answers that ki whether action is deliberate or not, it is just for understanding. Right? It is just for understanding. So let's say that you eat some of the things day-to-day basis, so you understand that, let's say chapati, so it is made of wheat, etc., isn't it? Don't ask that whether it is made up of, right, wheat or millet, etc. You ask. You don't ask. So it is understood, right? So, and when there is a change in the chapati color, etc., so you ask, right? So this is for that, let's say that. You have to have in the background of the mind, for a finer understanding of what is human action, you have to have certain theoretical understanding, and that is what we are saying, deliberate, indeliberate, etc. And that is how you will be able to explain in a given situation that when a soldier has to kill, so why it is justified. When in a disaster-like situation, few people can be ignored to save some other people, certainly those few people will die, so why it is done, and you can logic it. So, this way. And similarly, let's say that we will talk other aspects, but we want to give one such strong message about ethics, that any human conduct is ethical or unethical only on the ground of established standards, only on the ground of ethical principles, not other ground. They can be secondary and tertiary, they may be acceptable, but any conduct can be religious, can be societal, can be good, can be acceptable. But to say any conduct as ethical, it must be based on established standards or principles of ethics. Whether you agree or disagree, it hardly matters. Right. Whether you agree or disagree hardly matters. Right. Rather, you will have to conform to that established standard. Right. Why you will have to conform to that established standard? Right. Because you are not the first generation of this society. No, we don't know which generation we are. So, you have ancient society. So they set all these standards. No. That the society, when it has evolved, it has started setting the standards. Already many standards are set in, let's say, Vedas you have, Gita you have, Mahabharata you have, Upanishad you have, right? If you read them, so one life is not possible to read them. So, already these standards are set. So, you cannot say that your standards are better. First, we have to know the standards. Right. That's why it does not matter what you think. What matter is whether you know ethical standards. And that is how it is considered. And that's why it will improve your views also. You should not tell anything henceforth. If you want to be rational, right and wrong, unless you understand about that object. Right. Intention, purpose, consequence, situation. Right. Then we will say as rational thinking. Right. Otherwise it is common sense. This is what we'll say. So let's finish today. We'll take tomorrow. All the best, enjoy your life.